The time is now. Welcome, Toastmaster and Walley.
The time is now. As we approach what could be a financial nightmare for many Americans, the focus is on the United States House of Representatives. Mostly Republicans, but some Democrats and Wall Street CEOs are attempting deficit reduction that places a heavy burden upon the backs of the middle class and the working class families. Vital programs such as Social Security, Medicaid, and Medicare are at risk of dangerous cuts. Now, President Obama and the Democrats won a decisive victory on Election Day. And there is no doubt the feelings of an overwhelming majority of the American people. The United States House of Representatives, both Republicans and Democrats, must make it very clear that they intend to stand with the middle class and working families of our country and not with big money interests. This means that in the coming weeks and months, the Democrats must hold the line in demanding that deficit reduction is done in a way that is fair. Fair. And not on the backs of the elderly, the sick, our children, and the poor. Republicans must not cave in to the pressure of big business and must simply do what is right in the spirit of statesmanship and decency. We must protect Social Security, Medicaid, and Medicare. Now, as Congress reconvenes and addresses the so-called fiscal cliff that is coming, Senator Bernie Sanders outlined several ways that we can do deficit reduction without cutting the programs that working families rely on the most. And here's what he said. At a time when the wealthiest people in our country are doing phenomenally well, we must eliminate the Bush tax cuts favoring the top 2%. That can be done. At a time when corporate profits are soaring, we must end the absurd tax policy that allows about one quarter of large, profitable corporations to pay absolutely nothing in federal income tax. That can be done. At a time when the federal treasury is losing over $100 billion annually because the wealthy and large corporations are stashing their money in tax havens like the Cayman Islands or Switzerland, we must pass real tax reform that ends this outrage, and that can be done. At a time when we spend almost as much as the rest of the world combined in defense spending, we must cut defense spending. And there are other places in our government that we can find areas to cut. This can be done. These ideas of Senator Sanders, President Obama, the Democratic leadership in the House are not far left. They're not socialists or even outside of the mainstream. They are reasonable, doable, and just plain common sense. Here's a fact. Social Security has not contributed one penny to the deficit. because it's funded independently by a payroll tax. Not one penny from Social Security. Did you know that Social Security Trust Fund today, at this moment, according to the Social Security Administration, has $2.7 trillion surplus and can pay 100% of all benefits owed to every eligible American for the next 21 years. To quote Mark Twain, rumors of my death are greatly exaggerated. Corporate monoliths and Wall Street do not want you to know that. They just want to keep everyone from getting their hands on their money stash. Social Security, as well as Medicaid and Medicare, must be protected. Poll after poll shows that the American people want to see deficit reduction done in a way that is fair. They do not want to see cuts in Social Security, Medicaid, or Medicare while billionaires and large corporations continue to receive huge tax breaks. And as President Obama toured the country, he found that there is no state in this union, including those that are neon red, where people believe that they should give huge tax breaks to billionaires while cutting Social Security, Medicaid, and Medicare. Now, there is a great fear that some Democrats will cave into the Republican majority in the House and that Republicans will play buddy-buddy again with big business. But we must find some kind of parity here, because the end result is a disastrous deficit reduction that hurts those who are already hurting. President Obama and all members of Congress should pledge to do deficit reduction in a way that finally asks the wealthiest people in our country to pay their fair share. Fiscal policy should recognize the needs of working families. It is the moral. It is the right. And it is the decent thing to do. Mr. Toastmaster.